have a nice sugar maple here. This tree is, it's about 20 to 22 inches in diameter. It could probably support two buckets. We're just going to put one on for today. We're going to find a good, comfortable spot to drill the hole and to empty the buckets from, and that has a nice clean face in the bark, that there's no obvious problems or issues with the tree. I'm just going to put the drill up to the tree. Drill in. Put the spout in. And you saw that the noise kind of changed. It got in, it stopped going in much, and that sap is dripping out. We have a larger hole drilled in our bucket. It's going to fit right over the lip on the spout. So now all that sap is coming right into our bucket. This was the standard for the industry with the galvanized buckets. And you can still find a lot of these out today. You want to be careful when you're using them. Make sure that they're still good and clean, that they haven't rusted, that nobody's painted them, that they're not leaking. You know, some of them have gone into disrepair. But if you can get a good, clean, used galvanized bucket, usually they go for about $5 each. The new ones are a lot more expensive, but potentially worth it if that's what you're looking to do. And it's a pretty simple process. It's also a lot of work. Collecting the sap from thousands of buckets takes a lot of labor and a lot of time. That's why the industry moved mostly to tubing and now vacuum tubing, because you can get more sap out of the tree and it takes less work during the sugaring season. You do have a lot of installation costs and time to originally put it up, and there's some maintenance costs and checking your lines for vacuum leaks, but you wouldn't be able to have the large-scale sugaring operations that we do today if you were just hanging lots of buckets like this. Not every day is as nice and sunny a day as this, so we're going to put a lid on the bucket to keep out any rain or snow. And there we go. And we'll come back and we'll check the bucket just about every day the sap's flowing to empty it. And it's a great way to do it, and a great look, the traditional galvanized bucket hanging on the tree. Nothing like that here in the Northeast.